So about thermodynamics versus this class, kinetics and phase transformation. We talked about thermodynamics. We said it's more about read it to yourself, equilibrium, and the energy difference. Equilibrium, okay, they are the kind of same energy level, going forward speed, backward speed, or rate the same. And there will be energy difference. If I'm going to draw a schematic here, the vertical axis would be, let's say, Gibbs free energy. Neglect the horizontal, it doesn't really mean much. It just says we have one so-called initial state has certain energy level. We have one so-called final state has another energy level. And if the final state is, as what we illustrate, lower than the initial state, then we can calculate from thermodynamics the so-called delta G, the energy difference between the initial state and the final state. Make sense? The delta G would be the final state minus initial state, G prime minus G zero. And from what you learn in thermodynamics, if delta G is negative, the process from initial to final is what people call spontaneous. It would go that way. Make sense? It will go that way. So thermodynamics tells us the equilibrium, the energy difference. It also is concerned with the possibility or direction of transformation between states. Above the room temperature, above the 0 degrees C, ice cube would go from solid to liquid. That process is a process that we call spontaneous. That process is a process that a free energy change would be negative. Below 0 degrees C, from liquid to water, liquid water to ice, that process would be a kind of spontaneous process, also called energy favorable process. It's a process that has negative free energy change below 0 degrees C from liquid water to ice. Make sense? That's what you learn in thermodynamics. And I asked you this question. Do things always reach their most stable or thermodynamically stable state? Last time we said the answer is no, and we give one example is diamond versus graphite. Probably you know, actually, at room temperature, the graphite, the black, pitch dark soft stuff, is actually at a lower energy state compared with the transparent hard diamond. But diamond can exist at room temperature for quite long, quite long, right? We don't readily see diamond. You wear one ring today, 2 days, 10 days later become grayer, and 10 years later become black, a ring for ladies. That's not happening, right? That's why we pay the money. Another example is aluminum foil in air at room temperature. We said, okay, air, which means the air has a lot of what in it? We said oxygen, right? And we have aluminum foil, which is aluminum. If you study chemistry a little bit, aluminum is actually a very chemically reactive element. Oxygen and aluminum metal, in principle, their most stable energy state would be they combine together become aluminum oxide. But that aluminum foil, as long as people don't put acid onto it, people don't burn it, that aluminum foil at room temperature in air would stay there pretty much indefinitely. That's another example that things don't always reach their most stable thermodynamically state. And actually, that's how some people say the entire human civilization is based on. Otherwise, we wouldn't have any metals left. Otherwise, our body, our organics, our carbon should already combine with air, and people should be dead and become CO2 and water. Make sense? That whole thing can exist is exactly because the world don't always go to thermodynamically most stable state. And then that, why that? That's what we are going to address in this class, kinetics and phase transformation. Kinetics, and you would probably guess, that word just means fast. How fast? Speed, rate, that's kinetic. Kinetic motion means, okay? And it's about the rate, how fast, and the mechanism. What is mechanism? What does mechanism even mean? We said it actually means possible routes. You know, from one place A to another place B, there could be many, many different routes, right? Even if I go to here, from this room to my office, I can take the elevator, I can walk, and even if I walk, I can take many different routes, right? Initial state, final state are fixed, but there are many, many, actually infinite possibilities of routes. This class is about the possible routes, or so-called mechanism. Which route is the most likely route? Which route is the fastest route? Make sense? And there are so-called factors that determine this route. There will be internal factor. What is the composition of material? Okay. And what will be the crystal structure? That determines something. For example, if different people, somebody like exercise, he would avoid the elevator route, right? Because he likes to exercise. Somebody who has difficulty or who has to sit in a wheelchair, he would avoid climbing up the stairs. Makes sense, right? Depend on your own internal factor. But it also depends on external factor, so-called temperature, pressure, atmosphere. Let's say today is super, super hot. I feel very, all the building AC shuts down, I want to avoid getting hot, I would take elevator so that I don't get too hot. Make sense? It depends on external factor as well. Temperature, time, that's for human body, but also for material transformation process. Okay? Again, look at the same schematic. G, free energy, this guy, initial state, this guy, final state, and thermodynamics tells us the energy difference, delta G, final state minus initial state. It's negative, means it can happen thermodynamically, but as we said, there may be from one state, initial, to the other state, final, there may be one route, red dashed line, there may be another route, blue solid line, there may be more. Okay, the class is about trying to understand which route it may go, most likely to go. That's one. And as we said, for the graphite diamond case, there may be so-called phases that we say metastable state. The energy level is actually a little bit higher than the most lowest energy state. The most stable state, metastable state, G double prime. Okay? And quite often, the material exists in that metastable state indefinitely. And metastable state, there's also free energy change from initial state to the metastable state. That's also the Gibbs free energy change. And it's higher than the most stable state, but the actual process may end up at metastable state because it may follow this dotted line. And compare all these three routes, all these three dots, you would notice that the dotted one from initial to the metastable state, it actually goes up the least. It has what we are going to call a least energy barrier to climb, to overcome. And quite often, that's the process. That's the route. Also called the least resistance route. The process would happen. Okay? And also, materials is different from chemistry or physics. In a very important aspect that we consider or put a lot of emphasis on microstructure. Microstructure. Structure, but micro means we are concerned with stuff at the micron scale or even smaller scale. That's material science and engineering. Microstructure, they may also change. That's what we call evolution of microstructure. By microstructure, quite often we mean grain size and shape. What's the grain size? How big it is? 1 millimeter versus 1 micron versus 1 nanometer. Nanomaterial quite often are dealing with grain size at 1 to 10 nanometer scale. And their distribution. And of course others, roughness. Microstructure, that belongs to microstructure. The pore size and distribution for ceramic. For ceramics, okay, you have pores in the ceramic body. That pores quite often negatively impact your properties, right? You have a clay product. If it has too much porosity, what would happen to that clay product? It's going to be weak, right? Which means it easily shatters. It's also may be porous, which means stuff may leak through, right? Loosely bonded, which means if you use it, stuff would gradually come off easily. That may not be good. But for some occasion, that may be what you want. Microstructure. Okay? So that's what this class, how is it different from thermodynamics and what our focus will be. How fast it is, which route, how do we link it to microstructure? That's what this class. And the kinetics, it depends heavily on specific system. And we'll touch upon this later in using more and more examples. But I said, be very careful with so-called generalization. This is what we observe in one system. Let's translate to another system. Be very, very careful when you do that. Because we said every material quite often is unique. It's kind of the same to say every person is unique. In fact, every material is unique in certain way. In certain way. Similar like every person, different people share similar characteristics, but each of us are unique, similar for material. So that's why be careful with generalization.